Hi everybody! In today's lesson, we are going to study about simple present tense. As you can see here, simple present tense is used for the things that we do regularly, every time. And we do and we see facts, habits, truths, and permanent situations. Maybe you can remember from our previous lesson, for permanent situations, we all the time use simple present tense. But for temporary situations, we are using simple present continuous tense. So, when we think about simple present tense, we all the time should think about the action. We do it every day, every time, every month, and regularly, or nowadays, recently, or at the moment that you are speaking. So you can differentiate the verb. If you do the action all the time and regularly, you should choose simple present tense. And in simple present tense, there's another important point, as you can see here, frequency adverbs are all the time useful because you can see how often you do it. For example, if you do it every day, like breakfast, every morning, if you have breakfast and all the time, every morning you do it, so you can use always. But also you can use sometimes, usually, okay, not every morning, maybe 90%, maybe 80%, and rarely and seldom, very little and very limited time, very few days. Often or sometimes in British English we pronounce as often, is used like always and nearly 70-75%, and occasionally like sometimes 50-50, and hardly ever really really few or little. For example, if you wake up every day 7 o'clock, but one day 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock, or 2 days 11 o'clock, so you say, I hardly ever, nearly never. So always, all the time, never, zero. Okay, better than never, you can use hardly ever. So these frequency adverbs are not must. These frequency adverbs are helpful and useful for our speaking. And when we want to say, and when we want to focus on how often we do it, we prefer it. But for, as a rule, we don't have to use it. It's a kind of helpful items. Let's see some examples about simple present tense, because there have been some rules, and those rules are important because simple present tense is very easy and very common tense in English. That's why we should learn it correctly. For I, you, we, and they subjects, we all the time use verb present form. For example, I work in Ankara. So in order to make a sentence in simple present tense, I subject is here, and then after that, without any kind of suffix or prefix, never don't use anything. Work should be clearly here and bare infinitive. I work without S, without ing, without to, we don't use anything. I work, that's it. You work here. They work here. You study English. I teach English. So this is the action. I do it every time and regularly. So for example, I'm an English teacher, so This is my permanent action. All the time I do it. I teach English. But for she, he, and it subjects, a bit different. How we do it? Let's see. After she or he, let's make a sentence here. She works in Antalya. For instance, you have a sister and you work in Ankara, but your sister, she works in Antalya. So what do you hear? S. So never forget putting S here, because she works in Antalya. So she works means she does this action all the time in Antalya. All the time she lives here and she works in Antalya. She lives, look, in Antalya, because her job, her work in Antalya, so she cannot live here. She lives in Antalya. So this is the permanent situation in her life. All the time, every day she goes to work, she works in Antalya and she lives in Antalya. That's why, while we are choosing tenses, we should be careful and we should understand about the situation. If it is regularly and every time activity, we use simple present tense. What about in negative form? Let's see in negative form. It is again easy. In negative form, we should use auxiliary verb with I, you, they, and we. And after those subjects, you should use do not. Short form is don't. This is the contraction, okay? Contraction means short form. You don't have to say long form all the time while speaking and to your friends, to your family. In formal writing, formal speaking, okay, we prefer long version, but for speaking for our friends, for our family, with our maybe family members, doesn't matter. All the time we prefer short contraction form. Don't work. As you can see, verb, present form, again present form. You don't put any ing to s or the other kind of words. And you are not adding any kind of addings. You are not putting any kind of suffixes. So for she, he, and it, what happens here? Let's see. Does not. Also short form. Doesn't. So here, work in Ankara. What happens here? With those subjects, when you use does not or doesn't, you must use only present form of the verb without S. You are not putting S here. S is here. So it's a kind of like maybe thief. So when you put and when you see doesn't, you never say works. You must all the time say work. First form of the verb. In question forms, we do a similar thing. Let's see in question forms. In order to make some questions with the subjects I, you, we, and they, we are putting in front of the sentence do. For example, I'm asking you, do you have breakfast every morning? This is the question I'm asking you. So you will tell me yes or no. You will give me an answer. So, do you have, it means you all the time do this action. So, what is the positive form? Yes, I do, you can say. Or maybe you don't have any breakfast. So, you say, no, I don't. But all the time, not we ask in this way. We want to take more information sometimes. For example, do you have breakfast every morning? And you tell me, yes, I do. I have breakfast every morning. And I want to learn more information about you, about breakfast. I say in front of the sentence, what do you have breakfast? What do you have in your breakfast every morning? So tell me, eggs or bread or jam or honey. So I'm asking for more information, more details. In order to take more information about you or about the guy that I'm talking about at the moment, I am putting here question form. So what do you have? Or let's see, does your sister study? So I'm asking about a question about your sister. So I don't know what does she do, and so I need to learn about her. So does your sister study? You say, yes, she is, she does, or no, she doesn't. But after that, it is not enough for me, so I'm asking more information. So what? Or maybe I want to learn about location. Where does your sister study? Maybe about the university, maybe about the city that she studies. So what does your sister study? Where does your sister study? In order to make full WH questions, you are putting WH questions, one of them, in front of the sentence, in front of your question sentence. So the other person gives you more information. In English, simple present tense is very commonly used, and you should learn about the details, you should learn about the rules, because this is very simple and basic tense. That's why, in order to start English correctly, first of all, you should learn very basic rules. That's all from me today. Hope to see you another next day. Bye-bye.